Early voting opened today. How and where you can cast your vote.
Delayed and unproductive repairs leave student renters dissatisfied.
And they told me it was a cosmetic problem and they weren't going to do anything about it.
Find out how a lack of legal protection led to this issue.
Interstate construction has caused detours to a local trail. Find out which parts are undergoing changes. Welcome to this Tuesday night edition of UATV. I'm Jack McGahey.
And I'm Phoebe Harris. Thanks for joining us. Early voting begins today for primary and judicial elections in Arkansas. Voters will be able to cast their vote at the county clerk's office. Participants can vote from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monday through Friday and 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. on Saturday. Early voting ends Monday, March 4th.
As early primaries begin today, here are a list of names on the ballot. Democrat Caitlin Draper, Republican Steve Womack, and Republican Clint Pinzo run for the seats in the House of Representatives. Running for the school board is Tim Hudson for the Fayetteville School District and Jennifer Wilson for Lincoln School District. The final day to vote is Tuesday, March 5th.
Governor Sarah Huckabee Sanders announces plans for the Arkansas School of the Deaf and School for the Blind and Visually Impaired. This will grant $30 million to these schools. Sanders aims to provide more resources, better campuses, and give necessary safety for these students. Staff and families say they look forward to the upcoming changes.
In Arkansas, lack of legal protection leaves many renters in a bind. For students who rent, this means slow and inefficient repairs. Gabriella Falan joins us live with more.
A law that is recognized in 49 states to protect renters is not recognized in Arkansas. This leaves many students in challenging living situations.
I got back to my apartment and there was a hole in my bathroom wall. And it wasn't like super big, it was like a hole, but I mean, it was dirty and there was like bugs and it smelled really funky.
Julia Nowak, a University of Arkansas junior, has lived at Atmosphere Apartments for 2 years. She says when she came home early from winter break to attend a class, she was met with an unexpected surprise, one that has left her and her three roommates displaced.
My toilet was leaking. Right, and so the floors were literally crumbling. The people beneath us, the water had gone down and had ruined their wall, and the water got into their electrical fuse box, so they didn't have power.
As the walls and floors were stripped back, a larger problem was revealed. She says the water had caused mold to form.
We didn't want to live in the apartment, but they weren't giving us anywhere else. So we spent about 2 weeks having to like argue with them back and forth, like considering talking to lawyers, just doing something because we couldn't live there.
One local attorney says the apartment's management isn't entirely to blame, yet this issue is rooted in Arkansas's laws.
As it relates to the strength of tenants, in Arkansas, unfortunately, Arkansas is probably the worst.
Arkansas remains the only state without an implied warranty of habitability, a law that would give basic protection for renters.
When you're leasing any piece of property, that they at least have to have it, quote, habitable, so that it has to have the bare minimum. It's got to have heat. It's got to have, you know, functioning water. It's got to have the basic fundamentals.
Nowak says she just wishes it could have been different.
It sucks. Like, this is all actually my last semester of college with all my roommates, and we're all graduating. So the fact that we didn't get our last semester together was kind of sad.
While local representatives have attempted to create laws to protect renters, nothing has yet been passed. Reporting live, Gabriella Phelan, UATV News.
Thanks, Gabriella. For renters currently dealing with similar issues, Clark suggests reaching out to your local legislators to push for change.
Fayetteville's 7th Black-Owned Business Expo takes place this Saturday. Fayetteville Town Center is holding the event from 11 to 4. Anyone is welcome to go to the event, and sign-ups are available to volunteer. The expo is celebrating resilience, innovation, and the impact of Black-owned businesses.
Bernice A. King will come to the Fayetteville Town Center. Bernice King is the youngest daughter of the late civil rights leader, Martin Luther King Jr. This Q&A session will take place on February 28th at 7 p.m. Students and staff get early ticket access on February 15th, and all remaining tickets open to the public starting at noon on the 16th.
A section of the Town Branch Trail will be detoured until mid-March. The trail on Best Way Street will be redirected to the sidewalks of South Hollywood. The Interstate 49 overpass project has caused these changes. The City of Fayetteville will replace sewer and water lines with this construction.
A campus organization marks record attendance.
It's fun to know that other people are interested in what we have to say.
How this program introduces high school students to journalism.
A new sorority joins campus. Find out how this impacts U of A Greek life.
1 organization on campus has reached its record attendance this year. While being a college campus, the organization caters to high school students. UATV's Yael Evan is live right from the Journalism School with more.
Thanks, Jack. This past Saturday, there were over 40 students filling the halls of Kimple for the annual Lemke Journalism Project. Now, since 2002, the project has reached a diverse demographic and taught students the fundamentals of journalism. It runs for 6 weeks, beginning in January and ending in late March. Participants are from Northwest Arkansas high schools such as Springdale High and Don Tyson School of Innovation. They are taught by volunteers from the university's School of Journalism. Now, Jamie Tidrick Jr. at Springdale High School has returned to Lemke for her second year. She says the program helped her come out of her shell.
Stories and like, it's fun to know that other people are interested in what we have to say and like, yeah.
Carly, where it's like 3, 2, 1, and then point. Okay. I don't know, like you have to like.
Handed out in both English and Spanish to reach a diverse demographic. Guest speakers come and it gives students a chance to build up their interviewing skills. They learn a variety of skills going through a rotation of workshops reviewing photography basics, how to interview a source, and learning how to work the control room. Now, the program was named after Walter Lemke, who founded the University of Arkansas School of Journalism and the Arkansas Scholastic Press Association. Now, at the end of the 6 weeks, students produce a newspaper called the Multicultural News, which showcases their work from the past 6 weeks. Now, as the program comes to an end, students run to campus every April for the annual J-Days, where they get to showcase their work and celebrate all they accomplished. Reporting for UATV, this has been Yael Evan.
Thanks, Yael. The Lemke Journalism Project runs through the next 4 weeks and concludes on March 16th.
Fall to spring freshman retention rates have reached an all-time high here at the U of A. 95% of full-time degree-seeking new freshmen returned for the 2024 spring semester. Their retention rate increased nearly 1% from last year, the largest increase since 2020. Retention rates among first-generation college students also increased 2.4%.
A new sorority comes to the University of Arkansas in the fall. Alpha Phi will make the 12th national sorority at the U of A. Over 2,000 women went through sorority recruitment in the fall of 2023. The U of A will now be home to the 176th Alpha Phi chapter.
Opening weekend for baseball featured good days on the mound, and Razorback Gymnastics had their second best team overall score. For more Razorback sports news, stay tuned. Hey Hog fans, I'm Maddie Terrell and I'm here to give you your Razorback sports news from the mat. The clock's running, let's get started. Flipping over to gymnastics, the number 16 ranked Gymbacks had their second best team score of the season. The team finished second in the Texas Women's University quad meet in Denton yesterday. For the third time this season, Arkansas scored over 197 and earned the fifth best team score in Razorback gymnastics history. All five of the top team scores have come under 4 seasons with former Olympic gymnast and now head coach Jordan Weber. Arkansas came to play on the floor and won the event, scoring a 49.575, matching the highest score of the season. A highlight on the uneven bars was sophomore Reese Stroder, scoring a team high of 9.9. After 3 weeks on the road, you can finally catch the Gymbacks back at Barnhill Arena Friday live on SEC Network at 7:15 p.m. There's the buzzer, and that's all the time we have for today for UATV Sports. We'll be back tomorrow. For now, I'm Maddie Terrell. Stick around for more news.
We have seen a pattern in the temperatures lately, with chilly mornings and evenings, but beautiful afternoons. Today we hit a high of 70 degrees, and later tonight we will get a low of 49 degrees.
Fayetteville will be back at 70 degrees again tomorrow afternoon. You'll be able to enjoy this weather throughout the rest of the week.
Today is National Love Your Pet Day. From cats and dogs to fish and farm animals, whatever your pet may be, give them some extra love today to celebrate.
With over 50 dog-friendly restaurants in Fayetteville, there's multiple places to choose from for you and your furry friend to hit the town.
And that's the time we have for this UATV News Brief. Be sure to follow us on social media at UATV News. I'm Phoebe Harris.
And I'm Jack McGahee. Have a good night.